Ladies and gentlemen, I am Captain Max Villman of the Swedish Air Force 172 Squadron based in Ronneby Air Base. So I'm going to give you a quick overview of the debriefing and evaluation system that we are using during line effort exercise here in Keshkemet Air Base. So, just as the Lieutenant Colonel mentioned, an important part being a fighter pilot is to each day become better. And how do we do this? Of course, we need to fly missions and plan them, but just as important, or maybe more important, is to evaluate the missions after we have flown them. And that is why we employ some complicated software to see what really happened and draw lessons learned from this. So what you can see here on this screen is basically the airspace that Lieutenant Colonel showed you in another slide. You also have Keshkemet Airbase over here, and around here is the map of Hungary and Central Europe. For this mission, we use what we call the bullseye position to give reference of targets, air-to-air targets, air-to-ground targets, and also your own position. You can also slightly see some red circles around here, simulating ground-based air defense systems that the blue side cannot fly into, because then they will be shot down simulated. So if we could play the tape. So this is the start of the Comeo from last week. So this is an actual sortie that we flew last week. You can see the Gator formation, a Swedish flight taking off from Keshkemet, followed by the maiden flight, Czech flight, and followed by the Puma flight. So this was the blue side during this sortie. So it was all three nations flying on that side. Soon you will see red side taking off, simulating the opposing force of the red side. So here you see the first red side taking off from Keshkemet, a reptile, so this is a Swedish flight, followed by the Titan flight, also from Hungary. And right now you can see in the southern part of the airspace, the blue side has started employing combat air patrols to protect the blue land from any red aggression. And you see red side entering up in the north from red land. So right at this time, the rules of engagement do not allow blue side to push into red land and shoot down anything, because the red side has not yet started the war, so to say. Now you can see red side pushing south, crossing the forward line of own forces. And this is a simulated event. So you can see here Titan-01, one of the red players. It's a simulated air-to-ground attack he's doing on a target. Shizumin, thank you. So he's dropping a simulated bomb on this target here in blue land. And if we could continue. Now you see this simulated impact of this bomb. Shizumin, thank you. So now the bomb has hit a target in blue land, and the blue side has been authorized to shoot these aggressors down. So if we could continue, please. Zoom in. So here you see a Maiden 2-1, one of the Czech equipments, has fired an air-to-air missile that has hit this Titan-01 aggressor from the red side. And you can continue. So the system now automatically marks Titan-01 as a white player, no player, dead man. So he has to fly back toward north and regenerate to come up as a new target. And because of security clearance reasons, as Lieutenant Colonel mentioned, we cannot show you any more of the simulated weapons, but of course you can imagine that more missiles and air-to-ground weapons have been employed here during this sortie. So I think we can stop there. So